Nokia, from a river in Finland to a burning platform of fire and frozen water. Meet Frederik Idstrom, founder of the Nokia company. In 1865, mining engineer Frederik Idstrom established a groundwood pulp mill on the banks of the Tammakoski Rapids in the town of Tampere near the Nokianvirta River to manufacture paper. The pulp mill would go on to expand into electricity generation in 1902, but almost reached bankruptcy after World War I until it was acquired by a rubberworks company, which also acquired an electrical cable company. In 1967, the three companies were merged into the Nokia Corporation, and they did everything. Paper products, rubber tires, footwear, communications cables, televisions and other consumer electronics, computers, electricity generation machinery, robotics, capacitors, military communications and equipment, aluminium and chemicals, even plastics. In the 1970s, Nokia headed full force into telecommunications, and by the mid-1980s, Nokia was well into the mobile phone business. But it wasn't until the mid-1990s that Nokia finally sold off the rubber and cable business to focus strictly on telecommunications. With the explosion in cell phone sales through the late 90s, by 1998, Nokia had become the world's largest mobile phone manufacturer. Until, of course, Steve Jobs showed up. It's as if the entire telephone world suddenly gasped in a single moment. It was as if this one single day would render the entire Nokia Corporation instantly obsolete. But I mean, do you remember what phones were like before the iPhone? Today, guess where Nokia is? This week, CEO Stephen Elop sent an internal letter to Nokia management. The letter Engadget bills as one of the most exciting and interesting CEO memos we've ever seen. Ahem. Dear Madam, I have been shown in the files of the War Department a statement of the Adjutant General of Massachusetts that you are the mother of five sons who have died gloriously on the field of battle. Wrong letter. Ahem. Hello there. There is a pertinent story about a man who was working on an oil platform in the North Sea. He woke up one night from a loud explosion, which suddenly set his entire oil platform on fire. In mere moments, he was surrounded by flames. Through the smoke and heat, he barely made his way out of the chaos to the platform's edge. When he looked down over the edge, all he could see was the dark, cold, foreboding Atlantic waters. As the fire approached him, the man had mere seconds to react. He could stand on the platform and inevitably be consumed by the burning flames, or he could plunge 30 meters into the freezing waters. The man was standing upon a burning platform, and he needed to make a choice. He decided to jump. It was unexpected. In ordinary circumstances, the man would never consider plunging into icy waters, but these were not ordinary times. His platform was on fire. The man survived the fall and the waters. After he was rescued, he noted that a burning platform caused a radical change in his behavior. We too are standing on a burning platform, and we must decide how we are going to change our behavior. Hey everyone, that story is just so sad. I had to pre-record it. I just kept bawling through the whole thing, but finally got that take. He went on to say, and we have more than one explosion. We have multiple points of scorching heat that are fueling a blazing fire around us. What will happen? Will Nokia be rescued? Can they get back into rubber? With the stock doing ugh, and the CEO crying help, it will be interesting to see what happens.